Hi, I'm Guru here from IT for Change Bangalore. I'm happy to be here with you all virtually interacting, and I'll talk about the work we do in Karnataka. Basically two programs, the Subject Teacher Forum, STF, and the Karnataka Open Education Resources, KOER or KOER in short. We all are familiar with the challenges of the current teacher education models. You can see the slide. One is the issue of the centralized design, which is makes the program supply driven. And secondly, limited interactions other than the physical workshops. So there is no ongoing support to the teachers. So huge investments have led to limited outcomes. The NCFT document outlines a very powerful vision of teacher education, which is demand-based, which is collaborative and participatory. And this is what we have been trying to do in the two programs I mentioned, the STF and the COER, and through the integration of technology. The Subject Teacher Forum program has been going on for the last 3 to 4 years, and in this program, teachers learn a variety of tools. I will show you a couple of them. Teachers are also becoming members of mailing groups set up subject-wise, in which they share resources and seek support. I'll show you a few mails as well. The tools, I've got a snapshot here. There are tools for almost all subjects, from calcium for chemistry to GeoGebra for maths, algebra, geometry, to marble, which is for geography, and stellarium, which is for physics. This is, for example, marble. It's actually a virtual atlas. And a teacher can actually use a tool to go beyond content to explore issues as to why the dateline is shaped this particular way. It's actually a chapter in class 8. And there are a variety of maps. This is a map for the rainfall information for the world in December. GeoGebra is a very interesting tool as well. And this is a lesson which demonstrates what is pi. The diameter is 1, and therefore the circumference approximates to 3.14. And this helps the teacher and the students understand that pi is not a numeric variable, but represents a relationship between the diameter and the circumference. Apart from these educational tools, we also work with teachers on several editing tools. We only think of text editors, but here we have Concept Map Editor, FreeMind, Image Editor, GIMP, Audio Editor, Audacity, Video Editor like OpenShot, etc. So teachers learn a variety of tools and get familiar with what kind of tools will help them in their own working. Along with the tools, we also made them members of groups. More than 30 groups have been set up by us. Some of them are subject-wise, some of them are by geography. We have set up state groups, but certain district teachers and taluka teachers have set up their own groups at a district and a taluka level. And that's interesting because they have taken the initiative to create groups amongst themselves. The STF is not merely a technology program. It is really trying to take a relook at the way teacher education is happening by attempting to include elements that will make it self-paced, self-directed, continuous, and peer learning based. And this peer learning through the virtual modes is a powerful complement to the physical workshops. We've been doing this program as a part of the 5-day in-service program of RMSA, supported by the online forums. And so far the results are extremely impressive, even if I say so myself. Around 2,000 schools have been covered out of the 6,000 schools, and we plan to cover the remaining over the next couple of years. 32,000 emails have been shared across 3 years over the mailing groups, which are listed here. These are the URLs for the mailing groups. And this is just over 3 years period of time, and all by government school teachers, which is quite impressive. And these mails are all sharing, seeking, feedbacking, conversing. I'll show you a few mails. This is a mail, for example, conversation between a Bagalkot teacher and Taranath Achar, which is about whether FET tool for science has tools for biology. And he says there are 90 million tools, simulations in FET, biology should be there. This is a mail about discussing the periodic table, another website which shows the periodic table. A teacher is asking information about botanical names of trees in her own school. This is a teacher in Mysore. So teachers are also using it to ask help. The peer feedback is always an important method of development, and here a teacher has shared midterm question papers and asking teachers for feedback from others. Somebody wants a mind map in social sciences. Somebody is giving a technology support. How do you connect mobile phone as modem via Bluetooth? Somebody wants to learn Audacity and is asking how he can learn that. A teacher educator from SCRT Karnataka is sharing a website which has got 50 videos related to chemistry. These are just some examples of emails. If you go to the web link itself, you'll find that every day there are at least 20 to 30 emails, and by and large these mails are all relating to the academic and the technology aspects. Very few are non-subject related. So this is a GeoGebra theorem. There is a problem on CERT, midterm, paper example, bacteria is a natural enemy of man, etc., etc. That was on STF. I'll now talk very briefly about the other project, the KOER, or the Open Education Resource Project. While STF is looking at teacher development, the KOER project looks at reform in the area of curricular resource creation. Current models, we're aware, are largely text-based. They are one time, once in a year you publish and print, expensive, limited participation of teachers. The OER, or the Open Education Resource Movement, is an emerging movement that seeks to change the traditional ways of material creation. And we have created an Open Education Resource Program using a wiki-based OER portal, which is in English and Kannada. And it's wiki-based, so it's collaborative like Wikipedia. And therefore, teachers are actually collaborating to create resources on that. And these resources are based on their own subject topics. So it's a new model of resource creation in which teachers are engaging to access, create, and curate, which in itself is a teacher development model. This is a website in terms of current status. More than 500,000 pages have been, 5,000 pages have been created, 800,000 views have been made of KOER with over 300 teacher contributors. I'll just show you on the site itself. This is the way the web portal looks. And for example, this is a program for this year. There are different subject portals, and if you can visit any of them. This is a mathematics portal, which looks at different aspects of math teaching. If you were to look at topics, then these are the various topics class-wise listed. And this, for example, is one single topic, which is circles, which has a concept map, textbooks, NCERT textbooks, useful websites, all connected to the topic of circles, and lesson plans, activities, GeoGebra files, etc., etc. The website is also available in Kannada. It is bilingual at this point in time. We're also trying to integrate these two programs into the mainstream department activities. So that is through the curriculum, whether the textbook for the ICT program or as a part of the DEET curriculum revision happening now. We are also linked to NCERT in their own efforts at curriculum material preparation. And plans for the years is to extend STF and KOER to all STF to all schools, KOER to all subjects. Look at school having wiki so that they can publish their own resources, and to evolve into blended learning models using tools like Moodle, and to structure MOOC, which is massive online open online courses. This is all on the anvil. If you have any questions, you can email me. I'm not with you, so you can't speak to me. You can mail me at guru@itforchange.net. And these are a couple of sites on which you will get more information. I'm happy to be here. This is also the website. Our annual report is on the website, which talks about our work over the last year. That's something that we can refer to. Thank you.